SummerSlam, something else. No question, one of the greatest pay-per-view spectaculars of all time. All sorts of happenings, and we just saw one of the highlights. The Hitman, Bret Hart. I must say, his parents, Stu and Helen, were so proud of him.
I tell you, bring a tear to a glass eye, man. Helen, she's such a beautiful woman. Stu, I love him. I don't understand him at all, but I love him to death. And Bret Hart, I can't imagine how feeling it must be to win a championship like the Intercontinental Champion and in front of your folks, with your folks being there at ringside. I never had that opportunity. I bet you a big feeling, huh?
Yeah.
He's got to feel good about himself.
Speaking of having a feeling, Mark Thomas just had a feeling. Running into the strongly powerful Warlord who just gave Thomas a little ride.
You must want a short-lived career, son.
He may. And Thomas running into that brick wall again. Thomas himself put together in good condition, but when you face the likes of a Warlord, this man's a monster.
320 on the hook.
Goodness. And he wants to be Intercontinental Champion. You should have seen the look on the Warlord's face when the Hitman won the championship. He wanted to be first in line.
He may very well be.
Yeah, well, if that's the case, he may be the champion, too. We had an occasion to pick up these comments earlier.
Believe me, Bret Hart, when I tell you, when you meet the Warlord, brother, you're going to have the shortest Intercontinental reign ever.
You're not a Hitman. You're a Mark man. I'm going to squeeze a life and the Intercontinental belt right out of you.
I guess maybe he found a little humor there somewhere.
I guess he did in his little sick mind. And I'll tell you something. As we were sitting here, the feeling that Bret Hart must have had when he won the championship with his folks, now the feeling he must have with all the pressure on him and all the top guns gunning for him, including the Warlord, the pressure is there. Let's see what Hart can do.
Talk about being under the pressure. How would you like to be Sid Justice? I mean, he is stepping into some big shoes here.
Yeah.
Sid Justice, hoping that justice will prevail.
But I like him.
Yeah.
I like him.
I mean, he's got guts, that's for sure.
And I don't like anybody.
That's true.
I like him. He's got guts, and he's big, and he's strong, and he don't take sides. He's on his own side, but he knows right from wrong. It's justice.
He proved that, and whether or not he's going to be able to prove anything else beyond that, well, I don't know. Remains to be seen. The Undertaker standing in the way of Sid Justice, as well as, of course, the man who carries the Cobra, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Slime.
Every time I think about that, I go back to that footage, and all I can remember is the look on the face and the screams from Elizabeth.
She was there. She chilled. I just saw the film. She chilled. She was shaken. Macho Man was out. The Buddy Knight Snake. You have reached an all-time low, baby.
Right now, it appears as though Mark Thomas is reaching a low. Oh, my goodness.
I guess that was high, I suppose.
Well, in any event, this man shows no mercy whatsoever. The Warlord with his manager, the Doctor of Style, the Slickster, back to the replay.
Wolf, clean and jerk power right there. Didn't even go off his feet. Look at here. What's he got a grip?